The coronavirus pandemic hasn't stopped a Northport man from carrying out his mission to expose would-be sexual predators on Facebook Live.
NBC2 investigator Evan Dean sat down with this construction worker turned online vigilante.
Hey, come on in!
Remember that show, To Catch a Predator?
I made some cookies. Hello.
It was about 15 years ago when they set up Shop at a Home right here in Fort Myers.
Can I get you a glass of milk to go along with those cookies?
Sure.
What's going on?
I don't know. I just was talking to her, and she said, come down and visit her.
Now, something similar is back in Southwest Florida. Sort of similar.
You know why the I'm here, then?
Yeah.
What are you doing here?
Talking.
Talking?
Yeah.
Talk about anything sexual? I'm not here to protect kids.
I understand that.
What you did,
it's wrong.
You understand what you did?
Well, wrong. Way wrong.
The man behind the camera here.
Oh yeah, a lot of people don't expect it.
You're a little rough around the edges.
Yeah, no, I just be me. This is who I am.
Is Lee Bassett of Northport. His page is called Southwest Florida Exposure. It's gained 12,000 followers in just 2 months.
This thing has exploded.
Yeah, it took off.
It all starts online with chats on dating apps. Lee and his team pose as underage girls, and he says older men initiate.
You blew me off yesterday for being 15. Now I think you like it. Kinda. Pretty excited. And they're just full force, sending nudes, trying to video chat, you know, just graphic stuff.
Lee has adult friends who offer filtered pictures or even make phone calls to the suspected predators.
I'll just meet you by my house so that none of the neighbors see you pick me up or anything.
That's cool. That's the idea.
Eventually, Lee arranges a meetup in a public place, and it's all broadcast live. We're blurring faces of the alleged predators because they haven't been formally charged with a crime.
How would you feel if I told you that my name was Mandy?
That would be horrible.
That would be horrible?
Yeah.
Feel pretty stupid, don't you?
And I know I f***ed up.
I feel I've stopped people from breaking the crime that they would have. I feel that if I save, you know, one child, I've done something.
It's vigilanteism. I don't know another way to couch it.
Is the
independent defense attorney Lance Dunford gave us his take.
Is what they're saying and what they're allegedly being portrayed to do, is it terrible and heinous things? Yes, it is.
Well, in some cases, they're apologizing for it. That isn't helping their own case.
No, it's not.
Still, Dunford says he's left with questions, one top of mind.
My initial reaction is, why isn't law enforcement involved then? You have these people who are allegedly admitting to crimes openly to you. Get law enforcement involved right away.
Lee says he has reached out to police and hopes to share the videos with them. Northport PD says it is possible the videos could lead to an actual criminal investigation. But ultimately, they don't recommend citizens do this. They say it's dangerous.
Do me a favor, take that knife off your f***ing pocket and throw it on the f***ing ground.
Put it on the ground.
Have you ever thought, man, somebody could pull a gun on me?
Oh, every time. I mean, it's...
And you still do it?
I still do it.
Ultimately, Lee says his motivation, aside from protecting kids, is twofold.
Hi.
He has a daughter of his own, a 3-year-old. He also has a criminal history. Lee spent time in jail for a hit-and-run drunk driving crash that injured a teen. For him, this is redemption.
I'm trying to go out and do good, you know. I'm trying to be one of the criminals that don't go back to jail or keep doing the same crime over and over. I'm just trying to be a criminal that got out and is trying to do something good now.
Welcome to Northport.
For the NBC2 investigators,
stop talking to kids.
I'm Evan Dean.